Hi, my name is Ingrid Dam, and I'm going to have fun with watercolors today. Picked up some flowers, and actually had to buy some new paints and a new brush since I forgot it at home. But anyway, I'm going to do it and try my best with those new things. So it's a little challenge, but that's great. So here I go. Good luck. Have a good time. Just paint and have fun with it. It's really not that difficult to paint. So just put the brush down. I often say when I teach it to students, I say use the whole brush, you paid for it. So might as well. Now here I took a little bit more paint, which I usually don't do at the beginning, but yeah, I use a little bit more water, so make it lighter. Now watercolors are a different breed. You do not want, if you think you made a mistake, move on. Don't try to fix it when it's wet. They're not going to let you do this. So just go to the next one if you think. Don't try to fix anything. As soon as it's dry, you can go at it again. But not when it's wet. So just love those flowers. Here, I put a little yellow in there. This is good. So very often I say let the watercolor work for you too. And every paper will react different. So sometimes it reacts wonderful, sometimes it's very frustrating, but don't be shy about it. Just try all kinds of things. If you don't, you never will find out. In watercolor, one thing you have to realize, you can never get lighter. You can only get darker with watercolor. So if you want it light, keep it light. Use a lot of water. And again, I put some little touch, because if it's too dry, you can't create this anymore. Too, jump out afterwards, after I'm done. You're going to do it? I think you're a very good artist, I hear, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so. Okay. Just bought this brush. Expensive brushes, and this was only $17, and it looks pretty good for me. So I guess it doesn't always have to be expensive, does it?
Love. No. No.
Okay, it is. Oh. Now here I used a lot of paint. I actually loaded up the brush. And sometimes when you hear me say load up your brush, it means you use a lot of paint and little water. So actually, I was just buying those paints, and since I have so many at home, I didn't want to buy too many, and so I have only four paints, four colors, and it works actually pretty good. I'm surprised how good it works. I can create all kinds of things with those things. So when you paint with watercolors, I do not want to get the green too mixed up with the pink, because I think it's going to give me a tough time. It doesn't work very well. So I'm just going to do, and again, make sure to create different colors. I use ultramarine blue with cadmium yellow, and sometimes I use more yellow, but sometimes you use more green. So you see the difference in the colors when you watch here very careful, because I want some pretty dark, and sometimes you have to go a few times over your paintings. This doesn't always work right away in the beginning. As you notice, I'm very careful here. Don't touch it. And sometimes I really want to touch it, like with those things. I do want to touch it sometimes. Oh, okay. I love those little things. And again, I always say, there's really, you can't make any mistakes. If you do make a mistake, it's a happy mistake. And if it gets so bad, well, you know, it's after all just a piece of paper. So just let it go. As you notice, I keep on jumping from one end to the other. I never stick too long with one place, at one place, because sometimes you can, if you think you want to make something perfect all the time right away, and especially watercolors, it doesn't always work this way. Okay, I think I want to do one more here. Those flowers are pretty. And now I have to find out what their name is. That's going back to the brush again. It has a quite a nice tip, this brush. Now I always feel like you need to buy really expensive brushes, because you can go over $100, $200, $300, whatever you want to choose. But, and if you do want to be very serious, go ahead. But sometimes it's not necessary. We can have fun with just a few brushes like this. With one brush, I'm doing the painting with one brush, and I'm going to have a fun time. Well, what to do around here. Again, now I'm going to want more paint because I wanted a little, oh, it's blue, but that's okay too. It's fun to have different colors. Oh, here I kissed it, that's okay too. But don't worry about it. Don't try to correct it. If you think you made a mistake, don't try to correct it. Let it dry. And after it dries, everything can be fixed. So just move on to the next step. It's a fun brush here. I love this. You can go all over the place. And I always say, dance a little, dance a little. Don't be shy. Now, there's a time where you, if you don't want it too messy, there's a time you want to stop. Because otherwise, if it runs all into each other, it doesn't work either. It gets messy. I love to sprinkle. Now, if you want to sprinkle and really have good sprinkles, you get yourself a liner, that's even better. But I have a fun time with the sprinkles too. And I know people are like, oh my gosh, what are you doing? But it's just, at the end, you won't even notice it. Let's finish up the paint of paper here. I always say use the whole paper because you paid for it too. You might as well. But there are times where you really want to kiss these colors. But now, if it's too dry, it won't work anymore. But if it's not so dry, sometimes you don't. The more you paint, the more you will know the difference. See what watercolor can do for you. And sometimes you want to let the watercolor work for you, and sometimes you want to stay away from it. It's not always working. Okay, I just let things happen. Oh, this yellow is pretty strong, isn't it? Oh, maybe I didn't want it this strong, but it's too late now. One thing is with watercolors, once you have it on the paper, that's pretty much the end of it. Just change your idea of what you wanted to do. Or just work it out. So now I really have to work wait, otherwise I get mud, and I don't like mud. It's, you can go on and on and on, and I don't. And now I want to wait until those things dry, and then I can go with the yellow in there. I can make the divisions of some are in front, some are in the back. But this has to be dry. If I don't wait now, I just make a big mess out of it. So. You should just go ahead and try it once. You will like it. I know you will like it. The old saying, you know, try it, you'll like it. So you never know if you don't try it.
Okay, you're live.
Okay, now I just waited long enough to try it, and it took a little longer than usual because it's so damp outside. Anyway, now I can redo and model my paint, my flowers. I'm going to, they're pretty flat around here now, and now I'm going to do it. And sometimes I just hold my hand a little bit. And so now I go in there and then touch it a little. And so I'm going to do this once more. I have a sharp line, and I wash my brush, and I have a soft line. So do not try to save money and not clean your brush, because it won't work. I promise it won't work. So now this paper is a little different than me. So snuck right in there, didn't it? That's okay. Those are those happy mistakes which I sometimes really like. So, well, here we go. Let it dry. You can't do much more. If you don't like it, it's too big. Wait until it's dry and then you can correct it again. Okay, here the same thing. And as I said before, this paper reacts a little different, and I usually love, I really like Arches 140 cold pressed, but okay, now put it down, brush your, clean your brush and pull it right out here. Same thing here again, put it down. And I like to have those extra petals here. Okay, let's move it out here. And I like this a little bit. Or maybe I do it this way, or the other way. Just move it up this way. So, after this is all dry, I am going to go with the yellow in there. And as you notice, I'm so dark here, and I really now, only way I can do it is get darker. And I don't even think I can get much darker anymore. So there is a way of doing something and just wipe it out a little bit, and you can see how that worked. Nice. And just touch it a little and wipe it. So. Yeah, that is wonderful. If you figure this one out, you can practically do everything. I always start with the flowers. I don't know, probably I'm drawn to the color so strongly that I need to do my flowers first. And then the leaves are always wonderful fillers. Don't start with the leaves, otherwise you run away on you. And it dries very fast, as you notice. I move pretty fast here. Otherwise it dries in and it won't move out anymore. So I want to have this move out here. And don't give it the shape. Now again, I have it very dark already here, so I overdid it a little bit. But it's still working a little bit. By the way, generally, watercolors, dries always up a little lighter than when you put it down. It looks so dark and scares you, but it always dries a little lighter anyway. What I'm trying to do is just get the petals out. And here I love those little petals on the buds. So much fun. But they don't have to be perfect. Nothing really has to be perfect. Nothing in nature is always perfect. So if it's, and especially in flowers, when people say, well, it didn't look like this. First of all, I didn't see it. And second, what is perfect? Now, if you do portraits, this might be a little different story to it. But generally with flowers, you can be a little bit more creative. So now I want to have, for example, I just want this here, like this. I'll just pull this out here. And then I want just a little line in there. I go to the negative painting, kind of. And that really works out real nice. And again, don't work too hard. I notice many people, they just work too hard, and then nothing comes out. So actually, anyone can do it. I remember very much a lady always took some lessons. I can't do any leaves. Just put your brush down. Just go. Do it. Don't worry about it. Anyone can do it. And again, my most important thing is have fun. Don't worry. And you enjoy it, and then you just do it. Now see how I can get close to it now, and it won't run into it because everything is dry. Do this when it's not dry, I mess the whole flower up now. And I wouldn't want this. There are times I want to be very careful, at times I don't worry about it so much. It's just eventually just digging out what you want to dig out and leaving things that you want to leave in. I don't always know what I want either, but just keep doing. And again, I keep on saying to my students, most of the time, if it's not working, well, it's just a piece of paper, and you still had fun anyway doing it. Okay, where are you going here with this? Now, most of the people are very scared of dark, of the darks. So, but the dark will bring your painting out. If you don't do this, it will not look as good. So don't be afraid. But don't start in the beginning with too much dark. Just have lots of water on the beginning, and on the end it will, you can go darker and darker, and they'll pull your paintings to get to bring your flowers out. Now I think I can put the yellow in there. I love this yellow in there. Okay. Let's do this. Oh, I have maybe. Okay, let's see how this works. Right away. So much more fun, isn't it? Oh. Well, I'd love to. I really I really do like to dance around my paintings. So don't ever stay too long with something. See the dark spots when I really put those in there, how much the flower comes out. Again, as you see, I keep on dancing and dancing and dancing. I don't stay too long. And I'm definitely limited with paint today because I am, see now I'm doing the leaf. I want this one out a little bit more and clean my brush. One down here. And put one here too. Okay, no problem. The yellow here. Let's put it in here. Ooh. There's a time where you want to be collecting and looking at it. I don't do as much anymore than I used to. But there is a time where you want to relax and sit down and look at your paintings. It's very important because it can run away on you completely. Things are dry. You really can go over your oh wow, that's strong, isn't it? Oh well, it'll float in somewhere, I think. Well, let's move it out a little bit. Again, don't try to correct it because it won't let you do it. Just try to make something else out of it if you have a chance. one thing I always feel is very important, that it's usually the darkest in the middle here. So now maybe I need to go a little darker here just to take them out a little, because otherwise it's almost like you really have to get it darkened. Again, I don't have all my favorite paints, but it's gonna work. And that's why it's very important sometimes. Just try all kinds of different paints, all kinds of different papers, because somebody will say, oh, I sure like this paper. Why not try this one? And so here I'm going to do something, and I keep on trying to get this. Okay. I'm going to try to settle down a little here. Oh, did it work? I don't know. Sometimes you just have to try things. Oh, okay. Let's do this too. Okay, I think I'm going to just let it dry once more and study it a little bit, otherwise it can run away from me. So, forgot my head. Now, do wait until it's dry, otherwise if you lift it up now, you have everything running down. So, because this is, I paint pretty wet, so I couldn't really pull it up now. I just love to dance around here. And always have your brush washed out and don't leave it in the water. Then you can keep it for a long, long time.